Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome to the third and final Let's Sample Oxygen Not Included. I'm just going to do the three episodes this time, kind of get a good taste of what the game is about, and get your responses. So far the feedback has been extremely positive. Everybody is enjoying this game. We've got, pause a second because of that noise, we need to deal with that, but this is something that I do want to make a series on eventually. Though right now there are a few issues with this particular stage of development that kind of breaks the game later on, so it's not something that I would consider to be stable enough to make a Let's Play series out of. It's certainly stable enough to have a lot of fun playing, so no problem there. But I've got up on my other screen here kind of their roadmap of where they're heading with this game, just give you some ideas. They want to deal a lot more with temperature. Last episode I was really confused that this was so cold, yet the air next to it was still 81 degrees, but what are we over there? -450. So they're going to do a lot more with temperature and tools that deal with temperature, moving temperature around and insulating and that sort of thing. In fact, insulation is something I want to get into this episode. They want to work on the sustainability of the game, of being able to find more water, fertilizer, dirt, etc. Meaning, how do we make the game last longer than 30 or 40 episodes when everything runs out? You know, I assume that this world here for the timer indicates that we're just in a small part of a very large map. I don't know, but I've never been able to get out far enough to find out. We seem to be pretty well surrounded. Can I not zoom? I am zoomed. Pretty well surrounded in deadliness. You know, it's nighttime, so we're not getting to see much, but this is all poison out here and up here and down over here, and so we've got a tiny little pocket here of life. And then if we get much further into the research, we'll get more and more the ability to deal with all of these poisons and toxins and whatnot to make it livable over here. But that requires sand and clay and algae, which we run out of. Slime can be turned into algae. Where was that? Refinement? Biodistiller converts slime to algae. So there's a way to get one thing, but you run out of dirt before long. And I don't know of any way to create more dirt. So they want to work on, how do we extend the game? So that's going to be coming. Improved stress gameplay. What happens when these guys get all stressed out? I think at 100% they kind of explode, but it'd be nice if they did something at 30%. That's a little different than what they did at 60%. And 80%, they really start getting a little wacky. New biomes and creatures they want to put into it. They want to have buried artifacts and other hidden things that are kind of buried into certain cells. Where's an example? Right there. Buried object in here. Right now it just seems to be seeds mostly. But what else is in this list? That's probably the majority of it. More stress responses and behaviors for strung out duplicants. Anyway, so there are continuing plans for this game. It's still fairly early in its development. And it's still pre, what do you call that when it first hits Steam? Early access? It's prior to that. They're releasing it to the fans of Don't Starve and those who have been on their own website and in their forums, releasing it to them first so that they can help them figure all this stuff out before it actually hits Steam for real. So that's kind of the stage we're at right now. Anyway, it is nighttime with all that by way of introduction. I've done a bit more research since the last episode. It advances quite a bit. Opened up some more spaces in here so that I can set up some plumbing ideas. Let you see how all that works. More plumbing over here I want to put in. Not going to really be able to get into air handling with this little sample series, but get enough done to give you a sense of what's going on. They're sleeping, they're about to wake up. Let's pause right in there and take a look at our next duplicate. What do we have here? Blanche is a biohazard. All the vitamin C in space can't stop this duplicate from getting sick. So we'll get sick easy. Only good at tinkering. Everything else, zeros. Heideki? Hideki? Good at athletics, cooking, kind of, and tinkering. Tinkering is mostly, I think we decided, that was composting. That was about it. Maybe more will be added to the concept of tinkering later. Cecil is good at construction, but he can't dig. So, just can't operate a dig tool for the life of them. Cannot do digging. Is construction important enough? Do we have anybody in construction? Finding can build. Too bad construction isn't the same word as build. You know, that's one thing I would suggest. Make things consistent. I wanted to find construction over here. Or put build over here. Just can't. You know, it can build. Anyway, build. I don't see anybody with a significant building score. 3 as far as it goes. Otherwise, it was athletics, which is spread out all over. Athletics is generate power, is sweeping, delivering. So all those are kind of important. We do a lot of running back and forth. 5, 5, 6, 6, 4. Okay, so if we were to go with construction, there's still a 3 in athletics, though. All right, let's give Cecil a try. Whippee! Brent. I've got one last bed and one last table. So, he will have his own space. He's just getting to bed. Hey, guys, wait up! Anyway, plumbing. Is that where I want to start? I think so. Let's see here. Actually, let's just start at the beginning. What else has happened? We added manual airlock. This one will hold back water, liquids, gas, what have you. So that's the one that contrasts with this one. The only other one is the mechanized one, which is an automatic. You know, think of the doors on the Starship Enterprise. Walk up to them, they open up for you. So this guy right here will keep the stinkies from entering the rest of the place. This right here, the air deodorizer, uses clay to grab all of the stinkies. Right there. These guys, what have you, and convert it back into oxygen. So these are huge producers of it, as well as anything that has to do with slime. Contaminated oxygen. So we've got a little bit of contaminated oxygen right there being produced by the biomatter in that area. So this door will contain it. Next, we're going to be researching insulated tiles, which will contain heat. Also have insulated wiring and plumbing to keep hot water from letting heat into the building, that sort of thing. So I want to put together a battery room, because batteries let off a lot of heat. Let's grab this guy. You can see the heat's being let off of these. So 81 degrees. Now, supercomputer's 206 degrees, so it's letting off a lot of heat. Battery, 170 degrees. We want to build the bigger battery soon, right there, which is going to let off. Does it say? It does not. We've got to build it to find out. So we'll want to build a heat-insulated room, put hot things in, to keep that heat from moving into our environment. So when I do a full series of this thing, we'll have lots of specialized rooms and might even play with giving each of them their own bedroom. That's not something you typically see. Usually it's always a community or communal area, but it'd be kind of fun to give them each a bedroom and a ladder that pops up between every other one. Eh, that might work. Kind of a Rimworld vertical. where was I? I was kind of going through this. So, got that room done. We can pull one of these out. I want to keep one of them because it does make the contaminated soil, which is used to make fertilizer for when you do run out of natural fertilizers, which are right here. There's some. So, there, you know, eventually we could use just this. And this would work too. It makes contaminated liquid, which could be converted into fertilizer also with refinement. This guy, the bio... No, that's slimed algae. Where's the one that... Right here? The fertilizer maker, contaminated water to fertilizer. We haven't found it yet. So, anyway, I'm just going to ramble all through this episode. You can just glean from it what you like. But this guy is cleaning up the air. One of these will go away when we get this guy built, the laboratory, which we'll get into here real soon. But what else have I researched? Electrolyzer. So, remember back in high school and in science, you stuck two electrodes into a test tube of water and it let off oxygen and hydrogen. This kind of does the same thing. We're going to put one in over here. Ooh, they got it built. And this is going to let off oxygen, but it's also going to let off hydrogen. Hydrogen's lighter. It's going to float up. It's going to be up in here. We could then suck it out of here, run it down into, I believe, a... Where would engines be? Power? A hydrogen generator. So we can use that hydrogen to tap it as a fuel to take the place of our squirrel cage. There's also coal all around here, right? They're somewhere in there. Well, trust me, they're here. There's coal here somewhere. Anyway, there he is. And run a coal generator. I've never done that before. I would guess that it lets off quite a burst of polluted oxygen somehow. Don't know if it's just regular contaminated oxygen or if it is carbon dioxide or what it is. So that'll have to be dealt with. What was that sparky noise? While I'm talking, I'm just going to keep on rambling on, but I've got to try to keep the game running at the same time. You guys can be watching out, see what they're doing. What am I hearing? Oh, no, that's me. My mouse wire is running over a piece of paper, and it keeps making a little sparky sound. Never mind. Anyway, power, food, nothing's changed there. Utilities, nope. And plumbing. All right. This liquid pump draws in liquid and runs it through liquid pipes right there, which we can't see because of this conveniently placed little swirly thingy. Anyway, water conduit, an electrical conduit coming down from the power grid up here, dropping down to power the pump, coming up in a pipe. Go to the piping grid. Where are you? That's temperature, light. There we go. So we're going to build some plumbing today. Pop out of there. And plumbing is kind of interesting. You've got to keep track of... Well, that just brings it... We go to pipe, that's better. Okay. The inlet and the outlet. So, to me, it's kind of frustrating the way it's drawn. Because it looks like the water's going uphill. Really, it's a symbol that means it's going in and coming out. When I first did this on my own, I connected all the greens together and all the whites together, thinking these were all the outs and these were all the ins or something like that, and it just didn't quite work the way I had thought. But we've got an outlet going to an inlet going to an inlet of the shower and the lavatory. The outlet, the sewage, comes down, grabs this one as well, comes down to the inlet of the refinement, the water purifier, which uses sand to purify the contaminated waters leaving the toilet and the shower, running it through this high-tech, real impressive filter here to dump out fresh, clean water afterward. That's what we're going to build today and see if it works. I'm going to make this last connection here because they were starting to build it before I was ready to record it. Let's connect that together. And let's go ahead and prioritize this whole thing as a 9 and get them constructing it. Otherwise, what are we doing? We're grabbing water from here. Now, I don't know how, if there is a way, to tell them that this water is for pumping and this water is for drinking. And stop taking the water from here. There may or may not be a way to do that. Well, I guess there could be. Let me think here. Is there any way to tell this door disable? I wonder if we could put a door across here and then seal it. That might be worth trying someday. And basically say don't grab water from here anymore. Maybe we'll experiment with that this time. In fact, let's deconstruct that one right there. Thank you, Rosalind, or somebody. And let's try putting one of those doors in. It can be just a regular pneumatic door. O turns it around. Like so. And we'll make that one a priority 9. And something else I want to show you that I keep forgetting about myself. Whenever you build something, let's build a tile. We've got choices of what to make it out of. could make it out of igneous rock, we could make it out of granite, we can make it out of sedimentary rock, we can make it out of sandstone. It's odd to make metal things out of sandstone to me, but we have 70,000 of it, so we may as well be building out of that. Each time you restart the game, or each time you just load up your save file, not necessarily a new game, but continue a game, it starts everything off at the far left side. So you've got to manually reset what you want to build things out of. But kind of like in RimWorld, you click to build a wall and you get a menu that says, do you want to make it out of plasteel or steel or wood or granite or what have you? It's the same concept right here. I just forget it's there. And then you can choose your priority of how important it is to build it. So all that could be done before you ever lay it on the screen there. So there's a lot more to this, a lot deeper than just build that there. Now, what do you want to build it out of? How important is it? So there is that to consider. We'll let them build this area here. But you get the concept of it. So fresh water is going to go in, supply the toilet, supply the shower. The drain is going to come out of both, drop into a filter, which is going to filter it out and drop clean water back in. When I did this in my previous game, it did not make as much as it used, so it's not a one-for-one ratio. You're going to expend some of it. What I don't recall is if this also puts out like a contaminated soil as a byproduct. You would think it would. We'll see if it tells us anything in the pop-up when we get to that point. So that's that. We'll let them build that. Let's go over here. This guy needs its own water pump, or we could try to run this pipe all the way out over here. But I figured let's just go ahead and do another one right here just to get a chance to show how this works. So let's grab a water pump. Put that down. Now they can only go so far away to build something. So I think I'm going to build it right here. And again, well, we can only make that out of copper, but I could have chosen the priority. If I were to choose it again and build over the top, would it? Nope, it kind of freaks it out. Okay, prioritize 9 there. And, oh, the 5 that was on there, that has to do with running it. So you get a priority number for building it, then you get a number for how important is it throughout its lifetime. Do we really want people constantly updating this guy? You do want them updating your algae, because you need oxygen. But how are we doing on that? Still making insufficient oxygen. So that guy's going to be there. We're going to need power to it. And we're going to need plumbing. Let's do it with plumbing. This is the inlet. This is the outlet. So inlet goes to, or outlet goes to inlet. Could run it underneath here too. I think I like that better. And what do I need to get rid of that? Cancel that one? Yeah, I cleaned it up. Need power to this guy? I think it's going to show we're going to need power to this guy. Though it's not. Well, if I do electrical right now, it does show it to me. Okay. There. And this can run straight across. Power wires can cross conduits just fine. Where are we going, though? We need to get up into here. Let's just run it straight up like so. We'll make it pretty some other time. Right now, I just want to show how it works. And Marie here is sleepy. How are we doing on stress? 4% for Cecil. That's fine. So this all's going to get built. Spike is narcolepsy? What's going on here? Spike. Narcoleptic sleep. Stats. Yeah. So Spike is a narcoleptic. He, right? Do I know? Doesn't really tell me. I'm assuming Spike is a guy. And he just kind of conks out once in a while. Anyway, this is being built. Is this built? Power. We need power for this guy, too. Okay. Let's do that. Let's think about all that's left to make this thing happen. So, let's troubleshoot this. Power. Electrical. Okay, so we need to plug this guy in right there. It's kind of misleading when you see the red flashy right here. You want to connect to that point. You got to go to the outlet. Connect to that point. And again, I could have pressed priority 9. That's just a habit you've got to form if you want to get them to build it right now. But power, I get back to that. We're connected here, we're connected there. That's all that's needed here. And we are going to need that battery real soon. He's running out all the time. Yeah. We're constantly going to be running this guy. In fact, we're probably going to run out of power this time. There we go. Is it enough to get it going? Kind of. Anyway, connecting power to here. Once this happens, what have we got? Plumbing. Pipes. Alright, we're connected to here. Ah, I went to the red, didn't go to the green. There's the mistake. You go there, you go there, you come out of there, and you come out of there. Into there, there. Alright, I think that is all the connections this time. And again, didn't push that and didn't hit a 9. Yeah. This is one of those games that's going to drive people nuts until you get used to the game. Anyway, that is in, and we are building this. Alright. What I'm curious about... Hey, guys. So, pause. Carl is holding his breath. Is he good at being underwater? Diver's lungs. Yep. So he's comfortable completely with doing that. If this wasn't an issue, let's make it an issue. I want to disable this building. Will someone come down, flick that switch? Though it's odd you gotta flick the switch to do it. Okay. Can they no longer grab water from here? That's what I'm curious about. Nope. So, apparently, that means nothing. Okay. Enable. It's not changing anything. Okay. So, didn't change there in the little pop-up. So, someone's going to get the order to flick that switch. Anyway, do we have a system working now? No, we're adding the pipes now. Throwing the materials in. Building it. Let's go to plumbing. And we'll see it happen. Maybe? Well, we can see something's happened. Water has filled this pipe. This is showing it's fine. This one shows an empty pipe. Ah, empty one away. Now we're good. Water's flowing. So as they start to use this, Carl is already... Well, that was quick. But we're going to gradually start running... wastewater, we'll say, through. Wasn't enough to really activate it yet, though. While we're watching this, let me back out to about there. There, now we can see that. Let's put in a 4 tile, and let's do it right. Tile made here of this, priority 9, right there. Okay. Now, I could just seal this up, and then they can't get down here. That's one way to deal with that. They really want these materials, though. So, we'll let them do that. But, that symbol is what? Progress of the... I don't know. No sense of a progress here. I don't know. That is interesting. In my previous game... They would sit there for the longest time and take a full-blown shower. This one-second stuff wasn't happening then. So I don't quite... I wonder if that's an update. I wonder if they were taking too much time in the shower before. Still says dirty hands. Or there are still number 9s that they have to go deal with. The shower... I wonder if you have a priority here. No, no priority hiding in there. To say, you know, make it happen. Let's get rid of one of these bathrooms. One of these old outhouses. Deconstruct. And kind of facilitate... Ah, there we go. We've got a user. Carl. See, this is what I'm expecting. The bar is going to complete. To say that Carl... Yeah, is done with his job. Okay. And anyway, as they are doing it, we should see liquid coming down the pipes. Going into here. Filling it up, processing it, going out the pipes, and splashing clean water back into our supply down here. That's the way it works. Now, do you have any kind of a... Awaiting material delivery. Filtration medium. Alright, do you have a priority? You don't. That's surprising. If I force you, no? I would think that we'd want to make sure that the awaiting material delivery was not going to be forgotten for so long. There we go. We just added a bunch of sand. Now, processing. That's interesting. Is this waiting for anything? Don't know. Well, let's let that just go for a while. There was one thing, though, that I wanted to add. I just discovered it. Medical, right there, hand sanitizer. You don't have enough raw materials. What do you need? Bleach stone. The heck is a bleach stone? Bleach would be near chlorine, right? Chlorine. Igneous rock, bleach stone. Yeah, what's it take to get near that without breaking loose a cloud of toxic chlorine to deal with? All right. I'm thinking this playthrough, we're not going to get to see hand sanitizer. But what can we get to see? This over here needs to be done. Let's deal with this and food. 17,000. I'd keep track of that. Harvest 9. This guy. As soon as you guys get up, clean that one up. Seeds. We've got one more mealwood seed available to us. Let's do that. Let's tile here 9. That guy. And let's food this guy made out of dirt and clay. Interesting. Alright, I guess that's what's inside the box. Anyway, we'll put one of those in. We'll get one more seed going. What else? So over here, let's prioritize 9. Let's get this system happening. That didn't work. 9. Try that again. There we go. 5s. No, just do this group down here. Let's get this built and watch it starting to happen. Otherwise, I did grab a duplicate, right? Yeah, all the beds are taken. That was fast. I didn't expect that. I think I'm going to pass on it, though, for now. You, let's get all of the lice loaf that we can. Now, again, watching over here, it'll tell me if we don't have enough material. So far, we do. So if I pop in, max that out. We apparently have enough lice available, meal lice, to deal with it. Meal lice officially is a grain. But it's, let's see, how about right here? This guy. A flavorless grain that almost never wiggles on its own. That's them right there. So when they're on the plant, they look suspiciously like a little creepy crawly. All right, we're getting the conduit in. So this guy's going to make oxygen, which means we don't have to spend as much on algae on this. In fact, let's go ahead and disable these guys in the anticipation. There's two of them, right? I thought I put in two. Let me think about that. In anticipation of making oxygen out of water instead of out of algae. So we can save the algae for the carbon dioxide filters. These guys need to be taken care of. They're kind of in our way. I guess they've fallen down from up above. I'm not seeing another one of these guys. Algae deoxifier. Okay. Then I'm going to assume I'm not missing one and it's just not there. Alright, so let's dig that up. That up. That one. Let's see what's in there. Probably a bunch more seeds. In fact, it'd be kind of interesting just to watch it. Who is going to get the order? You are finishing over here. Marie? No. You're grabbing food. Or lice to make food from. You're delivering food. No, you're eating. Nom, 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 nom. Yeah, it is lunchtime. We are not going to go digging anything right now. Oh, the mouth on those guys? So, this, I believe, means we have harvested three times. This is an old plant now, and it's going to have to be replanted. And let's go ahead and make that happen. And then start over growing from scratch. I'm going to assume that they like this one better. This one will leave you with dirty hands. Cecil is still just taking a tiny itty bitty little shower. Still grimy. Something's not working right with the shower. What is it? What am I not seeing here? Let me look at the plumbing again. It's like there's not enough capacity in the drain. Or it's that they have a higher priority somewhere else. They want to do it, but there's a 9 somewhere. That's probably more of what's going on. That's probably a balancing issue that's going to have to be dealt with, because it does seem like it is working properly. Like, it's kind of neat, the blue and the green just give you a sense of what's happening here. And, you see that? 2 greens went in and 1 blue came out. Let's see if we can duplicate that. 2, 3 went in. 4 went in. 2 came out. And 1 is going to make it through the filter. So it's a 1-to-4 ratio. You're going to use 4 times as much as you're going to get back. That's interesting. So we are going to need to clean up this water and get it pumped over into the other systems. Which means we're going to need some water ducts. And, well, I guess pipes would be the water ducts. But so a pump into a filtration system like this, out of it, down a pipe into a drain vent, liquid vent, to drop into this guy would be more of a long-term solution. Short-term, just punch a path through here and let that run in. In fact, I'm half tempted to let them do that. I wonder if they will actually make that path. Let's find out. Let's dig from here to there. I'm real curious to see if they will scuba dive over and start punching their way in, let all this run back. Oh, got to thinking, you know, the building I was doing in here almost drowned one person in the process of doing that, but I was digging this area out, building these floors so that I could get ready for this plumbing demonstration, and I was working on this or something. I kept hearing this, I was like, what is that noise? And I'm looking all around, and what is making that noise? Is it a new animal or what? And then I found Carl here, hanging out of this block, his little body swinging back and forth, his head built into the floor, and he's just screaming and yelling and trying to get somebody's attention. It was the funniest thing. So, and the little Noble, he built himself into a wall. I had this guy right here, storage compactor, making all these little burps of nastiness sitting right here. So I put a wall right there to seal it up. And to build the wall, he went over to this side and built the wall, built himself into a space. And I get this little notice, duplicant is suffocating and all the oxygen run out of there. So you do have to babysit them a little bit. They will build themselves into walls, literally, in Carl's case. So are we content here? I think so. What's happening over here now? Aha! Now I put these in anticipation of this. Let's take a look at this right here. So we're pumping out hydrogen. That hydrogen has got to go somewhere. It would probably be a good idea to actually put a chase going all the way up. The idea up here is that the hydrogen is going to eventually build up in a high spot. And it's going to slowly work its way, kind of fill this whole area up till it pushes its way through that vent, and then do the same kind of thing here. So this isn't the best place for this. Now, I probably should seal these up, build a pathway up the side, and door it off and just let it naturally travel in a duct of some kind to get up here. Or better yet, now that I've said the word duct, is get into plumbing and get into what? How do we deal with this? Vent is the output. What is the input? A gas pump. Okay. Hydrogen is at the top. So how would we do this? Let's make this happen. But first of all, before I can do that, we're using up so much power. How are we doing on research? I want to get to, where's the bigger battery? I already got that, don't I? I want to get to insulation, though. Okay. Well, I'll run this episode long. In fact, I guess I will run it long. I just looked over at my screen, and There's no timer running, so I have no idea how long this episode's going to be. But let's get this process, build an insulated room, get the bigger battery up in here, to see how that works. And in the meantime, let's go ahead and put in a plumbing gas pump right there. And I want it in the air. So I want it higher, which means I probably need to raise that floor up. Let's do that. I don't think it's going to let me run that. Whenever you take the floor out from underneath something, it gives a warning that that there's no foundation for it to sit on. I think it stops working. But we'll build it there anyway. Normally, there is a... That's interesting. It's red here. Why is it not red there? Is it because it's touching the ceiling? No. Why will it build here but not build here? I don't know. Interesting. I can't build there, obviously, because it's in a floor. But I can build up in the air. I don't know if that's going to need a floor or not. Or if it's thinking that it's suspended from the roof. We'll see. This, I don't know if you noticed just there, constantly flowing water. And that's going to flow out quickly. We're going to use up water quite fast with this guy. Although it's going to hit his maximum pressure, atmospheric pressure, and stop working. There. It finally stopped completely. The pumping, though, didn't seem to stop. I guess it has to stop long enough for the pumping to hit its max pressure, too. And this runs... Okay, is it going to stop? Anyway, you can imagine we're going to run out of water quite fast here. They did not do any digging there. They may not either. They may not want to sit in water to dig. That might be a thing, but that's just an experiment. Anyway, with this guy, if we have to, we'll stick another piece of floor under there. Let's get power to it. Right there. Just run you up into here and go across. Tap into that. And your duct work. So, plumbing, ducts, there. We want to grab the... best to do this. We could run this through the floor too. And that's right. Stop me whenever I do this. Gotta choose a material that we have enough of. So let's run it an air duct into the floor. And let's just go straight up behind the ladder. All the way up. And over. And vent it. Right there. You would think... Yeah, right there. That it would, I don't know if I'm doing something wrong here. Let me think about this. It would just dump out anyway at the end of any pipe, but I think it has to have that end or the system doesn't register as complete. It needs a little green square to end in. But let's read this guy. Draws in gas and runs it through connected gas pipe. That may not be doing what I want it to do. The gas filter, I bet you, has to be in line with it. I wonder. Gas filter. Which is coming, right? No. That's pressure management? Gas valve. Where's filter? Filter, filter, filter. Meant by advanced filtration. Gas filter. Sieves one type of gas out of a mix composition, sending it into a separate pipe. Interesting. So we may have to use a gas filter to pull the hydrogen out of this area and send that out a pipe to a gas pump, which pumps it to where you want it to go. So there may be multiple steps involved here. What I could do, though, is put a door right here and just lock this thing in and leave it locked in as a hydrogen snow, because then we won't get the oxygen out. Interesting. What would be the best long-term plan? Put this guy up here with a gas valve and pump to pull the oxygen out of here, pump it down to the bottom, which then lets it float back up. I think about that. Long-term plans, is it better to move the poison away or move the good out of the poison? It doesn't make a difference. Harvest. Let's clean these guys up. We've got 21,000 kilocals. Let's make some more of this stuff. Everyone seems to love it. Here we go. So with this, let's throw a priority in here so we can see it done this episode. Research, we are real close. One more and we're done. How do we know when that one more will be done? That is this guy, which nobody's running right now. So that doesn't help. Oh, it's this one. And that's the bar right there. Okay, when that's done, that research is finished. Great. What else? So this is working. They're not digging. Probably not safe. I probably need to put a floor across here. And with a permeable, not gas permeable, is there a liquid version? We'll pause. It just finished. I'm curious about something. This is what officially? Blocks the flow of liquid without obstructing the flow of gas. Okay. And I don't think there is the opposite. I don't think there is a liquid version of it. You know, just a grate would be fine. Anyway, research is done. Let's give them something else to research just to give them something to do. Combustion, med bay, advanced filters. Just in case we get that one done, but it's 40 of them, so that's going to take a while. Now, I clicked that twice. I didn't turn it off? No. Okay. So, with that, we were looking for battery. That's right. So, let's cancel. Cancel here. And here. Okay. Let's put in base. There you are. Insulated tile. Nope. Let's cancel and do that one right this time. All right. Insulated tile that is made of sandstone and a priority of 9. There we go. You're going to go there. There. Let's see. Battery will be 2 spaces and a door. I think so. Let's find out. What is all that noise? It was kind of like that noise. But it just kept going and kept going and kept going. When I found Carl kind of hanging by the head right there. Where was I? Battery. I want to see how big the battery is. Power. The big battery is 2 spaces. Okay. So, go ahead and pop that in right there and there. And I guess deconstruct this guy. Okay. So, base. Cecil is out of energy. He's done pooped out. Insulated. Him. 9. Cross like so. Down like that. Into there. And then a manual airlock. Is that needed? This talks about letting... Right there. Letting gas and liquid through. But it doesn't indicate power. Or heat. So I'm going to say that's good enough. Grab him out of... We can only do it out of copper. Okay. So, 9, you're going to go there. So, did I get the priority correct on all those? I basically did. I guess we can have him build these as well at the same time. Okay. So, from there, we need power. And connect you to you. And where do we want to drop this? I guess right through here would look okay. Yeah, that would work. So this guy gets set up. When that happens, this can be taken away and give us a little more space here for something. How are we doing here? Boy, they're making that like crazy. Still doesn't say we're out of it. So yeah, let's keep making it. So we're starting to get these in stages. So we're not... You know, not feast or famine. That's a good thing. You are building, but will you run? That's what I'm curious about. It may give me a little warning. You know, lack of foundation and will not work. Building entombment. Oh. This fell off from up above. Interesting. Dig. 9. Can't use that bed anymore. That might be why somebody was walking around here really tired. Interesting. Any more of that going on around here? Okay. I feel like I was doing something. What was I doing? Right here. Gas pump. No gas outlet. It seems to be happy. Okay. So we've got to build these last two things right here. Prioritize. Or nines. Okay. That noise was this? The pump. Eating? Eating. That's what it was. Okay. I don't need any more duplicates, but that noise is driving me nuts. So let's just... Bottomless stomach. That can't be good. Dimensionally inept. I've not seen that one before. Incapable of visualizing an object in 3D spaces. Cannot build. Interesting. Good at creativity and athletics. Good at... Now, I'm not going to do bottomless stomach. We'll go here. One strength. Okay. Sure. We will get Zeke. You print. Just to stop the constant organ playing. So, are we kind of happy here? Last pieces are going in. Ooh. Not pumping. We filled up the pipe. We've not connected the pipe to anything. They're still building the pipe. Prioritize. There's the issue. So 9 right there. Okay. So he filled up enough plumbing. And grab the vent. Insulated venting too. So we can, you know, not transfer heat. So this shows how far it's built or shows how far it pumped? Probably both. Probably maxed pressure to that point. I would imagine some kind of an animation to give you a sense of motion once this gets going. So they've got to build these guys yet. So what else is going on? Decor. Not much more has been added. We do have the flower vase we haven't experimented with. I think we need a flower vase right next to the bathroom. This area is looking a little bit dingy. So let's get that one built. And... cancel. Let's do that right. Flower vase made out of sandstone. I wonder if eventually we're going to have pluses and minuses associated with the building material. Strength, you know, hit points as well as beauty and what have you. So put that guy there made of sandstone, and I still didn't get the priority. I want it done more than I want these dug out. Oh, and I've got to dig that out, and that's not done. Ah, that's why that's not happening. 9 you. 9 all of you. And let's dig. 9. Bed beyond reach. A bed beyond reach. Still have that problem right there. In tune, bed beyond reach, and cycle 20 report. Which just went away. Okay. That's complete. That's complete. Reports are up here. So, I think the negative net happens mostly during the night. I wonder why that would be. What is it that they're maintaining during the day that helps us to catch up? These are still making bubbles. It's not like they're out of water. There was a red over here. No, just unbreathable air in the area. This guy still says maximum pressure. So we can make pressure, but we are replacing some of our volume with things that are not oxygen. So that's the issue there. We're getting way too much carbon dioxide built up all over the place, actually. Ooh, actually, we are in a little bit of trouble here. Okay. So let's go to oxygen and build several of these. We don't need so much the unbreathable oxygen. What do we call it? Contaminated oxygen. We dealt with. We need to deal with the hydrogen is building up all through the place, through the ceilings. Interesting. Yeah, so when you do this for real, we're going to need to think ahead of time of getting the hydrogen out of here and yet allowing the oxygen to flow. That's tough. The advantage here is we're not wasting algae, but we do have the difficulty of the hydrogen. Well, we have a lot of carbon dioxide to deal with. And here's carbon dioxide. Yeah. So let's get that happening. Let's give this guy some help. Let's put in two more of these here. Again, let's manually prioritize them because I kind of want these done now. So, 9. We have a little bit of a problem here. Most of our problem, though, is going to be hydrogen. These two may be enough to solve the problem over here. So let's give pathways, continue to build pathways to deconstruct to get gases to flow up. So that one, we're going to cancel that one. And we're going to, let's see here, base gas permeable, 9, right there and there. That was a misclick. Cancel that one. Alright, so let's... These guys don't have any oxygen over here. We are starting to suffocate them from the buildup of hydrogen. Wow. Well, for starters, let's get rid of this. Which deconstruct just the building. Not the wires and everything else. And not all. So we'll take out the building there so that the hydrogen up at the upper side of this won't be trapped by this wall. It'll be able to flow through. So that's gone. Get this guy built quickly. Get that one built. We're running. Alright. There we go. Unfortunately, we're moving everything. So, we still have a problem. Pump not in gas. Pump not in gas. I guess for a moment, the game is calculating. It's taking away what's here and waiting for something to slowly pour back into that space. That's probably it. But we're pulling the oxygen out of here too. I guess in the end, the oxygen is going to drop. The hydrogen may drop with it though, just being dragged along. Now we'll have to kind of watch this. It'd be nice to get a little more space up in here, a little more air capacity, hydrogen capacity. But be curious to see if that doesn't allow things to start to solve or, you know, to fix here. This is going to help. Just looking at all this. This is still oxygen. It's still breathable. It's just not super breathable. So, barely breathable and unbreathable. Kind of mixed together. So, yeah, right here where the... Where the squirrel cage is, we're kind of holding our breath because we got unbreathable air moving in and out of here. That's not good. In here is... Carbon dioxide is in this area too. How much algae do we actually have left? That is something we run out of quite quickly. Organic. Try that again. Algae, 1,000. Why... Yellow. I wonder what the yellow means. It's being stored... Actually, it's being stored all over. As well as here. No, not here. Okay. I put it not there, but did put it everywhere else. Yeah, everywhere else is algae. That sounded like power shutdown. Yeah. We need to get this battery completed. Which means we need to get this completed. And we're doing it now. We're thinking about it, but we need to eat. Gotta grab some food and... Interesting. They ate the lice rather than the lice loaf. Does that mean we are actually out? It could. Alright, tell you what. It's still saying we have all of this available. Let's go ahead and do that. Just make it until you run out. Of oxygen. Yeah, this is getting a little worrisome here. We're doing a lot of panting. So, these are in. We are awaiting material delivery. Let's make these 5s. These are high priority. That, I'm hoping, by wiping out all the carbon dioxide in this area, it will draw it down. Hopefully that's the case. Water level's still decent over here, but we are going to run out. What we could do... I'm curious about something. What was that noise? this is ready again. This seems to be happening faster than I'm used to. Or if it was a little update overnight. A change of the game. Let's dig. 9. Right there. I'll go dig out the whole thing. That should make all of this accessible. Ah, we're filling this up now. Not only will it pull the carbon dioxide out, it will add oxygen, increasing the overall percentage of oxygen everywhere. Kind of looking things over. Got to keep track of all that's happening here. There we go. As long as we can keep harvesting these, we can keep this coming. Otherwise, we did get the bed cleared. We did not get this done. How many nines are out there? Too many nines, they may as well all be ones. Because nothing is of high priority. There's always the danger of doing that. Prioritize. There aren't a lot, though. I want to get this done. The nines here represent refilling it when it's needed. We've got one battery going. Okay. And we're pretty well insulated for heat, though heat really probably isn't an issue right now because it's not really working. That's more improvements that are coming. We are harvesting. Okay, so let's pull this guy out of the system. What are you? Gas vent overpressurized. I'm not real sure what that means. Let me try something. I'll break my thought. There. You go to there and vent. There. And priority 9 on that one so we can see it happen. I wonder if you need multiple vents pump. But anyway, again, this is just a let's sample. Just kind of going through the game, getting exposed to it, getting your thoughts, and just kind of give you a sense of what it's capable of. There's still, that's turned off, there's still so much more to the game that we haven't explored. But enough to know that we enjoy the game. Alright, nighttime. We'll go one more day. There's a few more plants to harvest. Getting some lag. I'm noticing I'm moving around. Getting a lot of difficulty moving the map. And tends to do that after running it for a while. At least on my computer. Out of power. Make sure that all the conduits are correct. Everything looks good. Battery went away, so we can deconstruct that. Okay, it's all looking good. Alright, so a second squirrel cage might be a good idea right now. And on a floor that has oxygen, that would be a great idea. Let's look at that. Floor that has oxygen. It is two spaces wide. It would fit right there. Let's see what that looks like electrically. That could work. Let's put one of those in real quick. Right there. And power it. Yep, tell you what, we'll just do that. There's no rhyme or reason. They just have to be connected to each other. Let's get more harvesting going on. Okay. You never got planted, did you? There we go. One mealwood seed. In there. Let's sweep up all this food. There we go. And was that... Let's make sure to complete our making everything nines. Otherwise, that could be harvested up there as well. That needs to get done. Yep. lots to do. Grabbing all the duplicates you can to have lots of labor would get all the things done. You'd also run out of oxygen faster because they're breathing it up, making more carbon dioxide, so you're always concerned about running out of algae. And you know, it's all a balancing act. Two people are sucking out water. We'd have to worry about creating clean water again soon. And boy, we have a swirl of carbon dioxide over here. Well, since this isn't a map that is, or a colony that is going to remain, let's just put in two more right there. There we go. We'll see if we can get this cleaned up before we call this one done, too. I'd really like to see this digging done. Tell you what, let's take the priority down here. And if that matter, the walls too. Let's just get this part completed. That's important. That's important. I want to see this dug out. I want to see that put in. 9. I want to make sure I got both layers in there. Okay. And you are algae, right? Yes, yeah, so we have a little more up in here. What else do we have in this map? That's all slime. Oh, that's algae mixed in with a slime. Okay. Another puffed over here. What else are we exposing? The further you get into the game... Did I see movement over here? One time in my previous map, there was a little clump of something that was wiggling. And it gave the sense that there was something inside there that was about to hatch. That was not a good thing. I wonder if there's another example of that anywhere. Seems like it was in water. No, nothing in here. It was obvious, too. Boy, a lot of sewage, I want to say, out over here. Slime and algae. So, in a sense, there is a tremendous amount of algae on this map when you convert all this slime. And there is quite a bit more water when you convert all the contaminated water and pump it up into a reservoir. So there's lots of ways to keep going. Sand and clay are also important, and dirt is important. Okay, so are we doing any of the things I wanted them to yet? We're dealing mostly in food. We have a lot of food, so let's cancel that order. No more food making. So that frees up some labor. What else would free up some labor? Another duplicate would, just to finish this off. Scaredy cat, afraid of violence, small bladder, creativity, medicine. Not dealing in medicine right now. Digging would be great. Let's do that. Grungy, you win. Print you. Okay, so jump in and do some more digging. We are definitely running out of air over here. Yeah. Again, carbon dioxide and hydrogen. So mostly it's a hydrogen, and mostly it's we need this pathway. That's about all there is to it. We need that pathway. Got to get this done. So, what do we do? Let's unprioritize everything else. And no, not that. Let's make sure that gets done. Someone went up here, so I guess they were working on that. Probably get the pipe in behind it. Just watching things here. What are you doing? You were grabbing materials to go off and build something with it, weren't you? And delivering it right over here. Alright, so there's our last conduit. No, that's the insulated tile going in. Like the animations of the batteries. Now the tile's going to go in. Is the wire going to go in as well? Ah, that's the symbol right there. Missing foundation. It was connected, but it would not run because the foundation wasn't there. Okay. Building this one now. Not building that one yet. Squirrel cage is going to help keep things powered up. Okay, that system's done. So little by little, it's all starting to go in. We'll have two people running squirrel cages here pretty soon. And we're going up to build this. Nope. We're digging this. Yes. What's inside there? A sand. Interesting. I thought for sure we'd have a buried object in there. But apparently not. This is getting built. Okay. Curious to see if we are no longer overpressurized when this gets finished. Let's watch this. Zeke must not have a great construction rating. Zeke, build. Right there. Zero. That's why it took a while. Alright, this one is not saying overpressurized, but this one is. Wonder if that would reset with the game being turned on next time. Don't know. Alright. Have we got done most of what we wanted to get done? This is working not continuously, but it's doing a better job. I see. So if we got a third and fourth vent into here, then he may run continuously. So that's something we could put in over here to suck this air out, drawing oxygen and other gases through this area and cleaning this up. Aha. All the little strategies I'm kind of getting for a long-term playthrough. Research center is idle. I want to see this done next. Again, priorities. That got downgraded to do other things. Okay, let's get this one upgraded and let's see this happen. Then we will call this one done. And what I've noticed, I can have all kinds of nines set up. When I set another nine, they tend to go to that one. So I'm wondering if they kind of hit the most recent one first. That's my guess. Let's see this whole area break free. See all this water flow from here to there. It shouldn't overflow anything. And then we'll probably call this one done. I'm kind of surprised at the shower, though. That's not acting the way that I'm used to. Okay, we can't go any further here because we can't climb any higher. Curious to see what's going to happen when they get over here. We've seen them scuba dive, so we know they can swim. Alright, breaking loose. Almost. Okay. Well, we'll let it go a few more minutes so we can see that happen. What else is there to explore before we call this one done? We are both overpressurized, so if any of you know what that's about, let me know. Does this require more than one duct to operate properly? Is this too powerful for a single duct system? Is that what's going on here? Otherwise, let's take a peek at our gases. Alright, we've cleared up a lot of the carbon dioxide down here. Haven't done it yet over here. There's no hydrogen in this area. Okay. This is all carbon dioxide. A lot of hydrogen trapped over here. I would probably want to build a duct right here. I wonder if we can put in passive duct works. Meaning, just have the ducts. Now the vent, are you only the outlet? Yes, you're the output. What is the input? Is that noise? Ah. I'm guessing that black is hydrogen and white is oxygen. It's telling you what's going through here. Interesting. Just looking to see if that changed in between. Doesn't. So the vent is the output. Is there a passive input or do you have to have a gas pump? It looks like you do. I guess venting between rooms is really done right there, gas permeable tile, rather than a duct that has an input here and a pathway and then an output here and just let it naturally drift. That's what I would like to be able to do. But I guess we just call that a ladder. Yeah, if we were to ladder right there, 9, and run this guy up into there. Didn't like that, did ya? Because the plant's there. Okay, so let's dig 9 there. Let's cancel that. And we've got this to dig up. We'll cancel that. So if they get to this thing, then we can pull the hydrogen out in that way. And it'll dump it into this space here. We can pop that and get it up and out. Anyway, we did kind of break free. We still got to deal with these, and we cannot. They can't get down there anymore. All right. So let's 9 down to that. Just to hopefully see this happen. So is there anything else that I need to show you to call this Let's Sample completed? Batteries are storing up nicely. 2 squirrel cages are going. We're going to soon vent the oxygen out of here. This needs to go away. Cancel that. Ladder. 9. That. That would help them. Yeah, they would continue at that point. We broke through. And we're going to pull this stuff out. There we go. That's what I wanted to see. In fact, you could cancel. Never mind. That's going to flow all this over to here. It's going to fill that up, keep that pump underwater for a long time. Okay, this is all looking pretty good. Let's let this vent and let's watch the hydrogen rise out of here and this clean up. And that will probably end this episode. These guys are doing fine. Click on the plant and you can choose its priority to make sure they tend to that plant first priority. So that's important if you want to eat. Speaking of eating, we still have 33,000. Okay. So we're building, breaking through, and let's get this torn up. I'd love to get that one done. Unreachable. That was the reason right there. No 2-space tall pathway to get to it. That's why that didn't work. And they can't get up and over to get through here to get to that. What is the... right there. Probably have some... through all that, we don't have any stress. That's amazing. Can hardly breathe. Overworked. Running squirrel cages. All right, so that area is done. This area... getting there. We could just get this done. Let's try digging one more time. There we go. You're holding your breath. Okay. There. We're through. Now we should see some of the hydrogen from here starting to flow upward, and hopefully some oxygen starting to drift from all sides as this starts to vent. That's what I'm hoping we're going to see. That little red just went up and over. It's not happening as fast as I would expect. Okay. But that's the idea. As the game continues to improve, I'm sure the movement of gases will also be reworked and improved upon. A lot of carbon dioxide over here. Anyway, I could ramble on like this for the next couple of hours. I'm going to call this one done here. I thank you guys for watching, and you know, let me know what you think of the game in general, and how excited you are to see a Let's Play on my channel of this game. And subscribe if you haven't already, and hit the like. I'd really appreciate it. And I will catch you guys next time. Bye-bye.